Welcome to the second step for coding our image crossfade project using jQuery. It's time to look at the coding for rotating in the remaining images. We will do that after the crossfade has ended. To detect when the crossfade has ended, we can use the jQuery fadeout methods complete handler. The code we have completed so far uses our CSS active class to select the fadeout img element. Once it's faded out, we need to move the active class to the faded over img element. For that, we can use the jQuery addClass and removeClass methods. We also need to use the jQuery CSS method to set the z-index of the newly faded in img element. We will move the active class once the fadeout is over. To do that, we can use the jQuery fadeout methods complete argument. It calls a function when the fadeout animation completes. Let's set that up and test it. Copy snippet 1 and replace line 13 in the crossfade.js file. Save and refresh. Click the next button once. When the fadeout ends after the 1.5 second duration, we see the console message in our function appear. Further clicks, the message appears immediately. Remember that the img active class element is hidden, so the fadeout animation never starts, and the fadeout method only calls the complete function when the animation completes. Now let's start moving the active class to the next img element. We can use the jQuery addClass and removeClass methods. Copy snippet 2, paste as line 16 in the crossfade.js file. Once the fadeout is complete, the img active class element is hidden, so it's a good time to remove its active class, and also a good time to assign the active class to its sibling img element. Refresh and click the next button one time. You can see jQuery changing the next img element's opacity, and when it's done, you see the active class move from the first to the second img element. Let's click next a second time. The fadeout seems to have been skipped, but you can see jQuery changing the opacity for the second img element. The fadeout did occur, it was just hidden by the third img element. Notice that the second and third img elements have the same z-index of 2, so the web browser had to pick one, and it picked the third one. Finally, we do see that the active class was removed from the second img element and added to the third img element. Click the next button a third time, and now we see no images. The reason is that all three now have their display property set to none. Also, the active class is no longer assigned to any of the img elements. You can go on clicking the next button, but nothing will change visually or for their properties. To solve that, we need to start managing the z-index property once the fadeout completes. Copy snippet 3, replace lines 16 to 19 in the crossfade.js file. The removeClass method returns a jQuery reference to the active class img element. That allows us to append the jQuery CSS method, as you see on lines 17 and 18. And the same works for the addClass method on lines 20 and 21. Now let's look at how we are managing the z-index property. On line 11, we move the next img element to become second from the top of the z-index stack. Then we faded out the top img element in the stack. Once it's fade out completed, we remove the z-index property. This puts it below the next img element. And finally, for the new active img element, we set the z-index to 3. Refresh and click the next button one time. Now you can see the second img element has a style attribute with a z-index of 3. Repeat the next button a second time. During the fadeout, the third img element has a z-index of 2. At the end of the fadeout, only the active class has a z-index, and its value is 3. Now click the next button one more time. We are back to a blank screen, and we no longer see the active class in any img element. This state does not change if you continue to click the next button. So why a blank screen after the last img element? One part of the answer is that the img element display properties are all set to none. The other part involves our using the jQuery next method to select the img sibling. When the active class is the last element, there is no next img sibling to select. We will solve that problem in our next video segment. Now let's look at what we did in this segment. We used the fadeout method's complete argument. That let us write the code needed after each crossfade ends. The first code was to pass our CSS active class to each new fadeover img element. We used the jQuery addClass and removeClass methods to do that. Finally, we maintained the zindex properties of the fade2 and fadeover img elements in anticipation of the next crossfade event. Now we can move on to solve the problem of going from the last to the first img element.